हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल एंड थैंक्स फॉर क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस वीडियो। एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट द मसल्स ऑफ द लोअर लिम एंड सिक्वेंशियल MR इमेजेस एंड देयर अटैचमेंट्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई विल बी कवरिंग द मसल्स ऑफ ग्लूटियल रीजन एंड थाई and muscles of leg and foot. So let's first start with the muscles of gluteal region and thigh. So before going further, let's first see what is the rule of 3, 4 and 5 and 6. It is a formula through which we can remember the muscles of gluteal region easily. So according to this, there are 3 muscles in the lateral quadrant, there are 4 muscles in the anterior quadrant, there are 5 muscles in the medial quadrant, and there are 6 muscles in the posterior quadrant. So let's see one by one. So the 3 lateral quadrant muscles are tensor fasciae lata, gluteus medius and gluteus minimus, and all these muscles have a similar function, that is abduction and medial rotation of thigh. Then we have 4 anterior quadrant muscles which are rectus femoris, sartorius, iliopsoas and pectineus, and all these muscles are responsible for flexion of thigh, and they are supplied by one single nerve. Then there are 5 medial quadrant muscles. These are adductor longus, brevis, magnus, gracilis and obturator externus. All these muscles are responsible for adduction of thigh, and they are all supplied by obturator nerve. Then we have 6 posterior quadrant muscles, which are gluteus maximus, piriformis, quadratus femoris, obturator internus and superior and inferior gemellus. And all these muscles are responsible for extension of thigh. So let's see the lateral quadrant muscles first. So first we have gluteus medius, which takes its origin from the iliac fossa, and it inserts over the posterolateral facet over the greater trochanter. Then we have gluteus minimus, which lie deep to the gluteus medius, and it inserts over the anterior facet of greater trochanter. Then we have tensor fasciae lata, which takes its origin from the anterior superior iliac spine, and it inserts over the iliotibial band. So let's see the axial MR images. We can see here gluteus minimus and gluteus medius. This is gluteus maximus. Then this is the anterior superior iliac spine, which is the origin site of tensor fasciae lata. Then as we move down, we can see gluteus minimus and medius are approaching towards their insertion. And we can see that tensor fasciae lata is now a little more bulkier. Now we can see tensor fasciae lata is inserting over the iliotibial band. And these gluteus medius and minimus muscles are approaching towards their insertion over the greater trochanter. So these were the 3 lateral quadrant muscles. Now let's see the anterior quadrant muscles, which are 4 in number. First is the psoas major muscle, which arises from the transverse process and vertebral bodies of the lumbar spine. And it is a bulky muscle. It inserts over the lesser trochanter. Then we have iliacus muscle, which arises from the iliac fossa. And it also inserts over the lesser trochanter by forming a conjoint tendon with the psoas major muscle. Then we have rectus femoris muscle, which is a special muscle because it has 2 heads. First is the direct head, which arises from anterior inferior iliac spine. And second is the indirect or reflected head, which arises from the acetabular rim. Then it crosses the hip joint as well as knee joint, and it inserts over the patella along with other quadriceps femoris muscles. Then we have sartorius muscle, which arises from anterior superior iliac spine, crosses two joints, and inserts over the anteromedial aspect of tibia. Then we have pectineus muscle, which arises from the superior pubic ramus, and it inserts over the femur. And it forms the base of the femoral triangle. It is the landmark where we can see femoral neurovascular bundle anterior to the muscle. Let's see rectus femoris. As I have already described, that rectus femoris has two heads, direct and indirect head. And when we see the cross section of the muscle, we can see that it has a small tendon inside it, which is indirect head, and then there is superficial tendon which arising from the direct head. This is the MR image, axial and sagittal, where we can see rectus femoris. So we can see here small tendon inside the muscle and its origin from the anterior inferior iliac spine. Let's see other quadriceps femoris muscle. This is vastus lateralis, this is vastus medialis, and vastus intermedius. So all these muscles, they arise from femur and they insert over patella by forming a conjoint tendon with the rectus femoris, and together they form quadriceps tendon. Now let's see the anterior quadrant muscles. We can see here iliopsoas muscle bilaterally, and this was the anterior superior iliac spine. Now let's go down. Now we can start seeing the sartorius muscle. Now this is anterior inferior iliac spine, which is the site for origin of rectus femoris. So as we are going down, we can see rectus femoris has started appearing, and also we can see pectineus muscle. Now we can see the femoral neurovascular bundle is lying anterior to the pectineus muscle. And the iliopsoas muscle is going towards its insertion over the lesser trochanter. Now let's see the thigh. We can see here the deepest muscle in the anterior quadrant of thigh is vastus intermedius. Superficial to that is rectus femoris, and anteromedially we have sartorius. Now let's move down. We can see vastus intermedius, vastus lateralis, rectus femoris, and sartorius. As we move down, we can see all four quadriceps femoris muscle. And sartorius is moving more medially and along with the gracilis and semitendinosus. Sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus, all these three muscles will form pes inserine tendons, and they will insert over the anteromedial aspect of tibia. Now let's see the medial quadrant muscles. This is adductor longus, adductor brevis, and adductor magnus. So we can see these adductor muscles are taking origin from the pubic symphysis and inferior pubic ramus. Adductor magnus is the largest adductor group muscle, and we can see it forms a adductor hiatus through which femoral neurovascular bundle, they travel from anterior to the posterior quadrant of thigh. And adductor magnus is also a hybrid muscle because it has two nerve supply. The adductor component of the adductor magnus gets its supply from obturator nerve, whereas the hamstring component, which arises from the ischial tuberosity, it takes its origin from its nerve supply from the sciatic nerve. Then we have gracilis muscle, which is a very thin and fragile muscle, and it arises from the inferior pubic ramus, and it inserts over the anteromedial aspect of tibia. As I have already described, that gracilis, sartorius, and semitendinosus, they form pes inserine tendons. Then this is obturator externus, which arises from the walls of the obturator foramen and its fascia, and it inserts over the femur. So all these muscles are supplied by obturator nerve, and they are responsible for adduction of the thigh. Now let's see the MR images. We can see a pubic symphysis. As we move down, we can see obturator externus. Further down, we can see adductor muscles. And in the proximal thigh, we can differentiate adductor brevis, longus and magnus, and gracilis from each other. Gracilis is the medial most muscle. Now moving down, we can see this is gracilis, and what is this muscle? Sartorius. So here both muscles are closely related, and this muscle is semitendinosus, and all these three muscles are moving towards their insertion. Now let's see the posterior quadrant muscles, which are 6 in number. So first is the gluteus maximus, which arises from the sacrum and iliac bone, and it inserts over the femur and iliotibial band. Then we have obturator internus, which arises from the internal border of the obturator foramen and fascia, and it inserts over the greater trochanter inner aspect. Then we have superior and inferior gamelli and quadratus femoris. And we have another important muscle, that is piriformis. And piriformis is very important muscle because it fills the greater sciatic notch, and it is closely related to sciatic nerve. So if there is any abnormality in the piriformis muscle, any asymmetry or inflammation, it can cause compression over the sciatic nerve and lead to sciatica. Now let's see the sequential MR images. This is gluteus maximus. This is piriformis. This is obturator internus. As we are moving down, we can see the gamelli muscles and the quadratus femoris. Quadratus femoris lie between the greater trochanter and ischial tuberosity. And we can also see here sciatic nerve. Now let's see the ischial tuberosity attachments, which form hamstring group of muscles. So this is ischial tuberosity, and we can see this muscle, semimembranosus muscle, is arising from the lateral aspect of ischial tuberosity, and it is inserting over the posterior medial tibia. Then we have semitendinosus and biceps femoris. Both these muscles have conjoint origin from the ischial tuberosity, but they follow different direction. Like semitendinosus moves medially and biceps femoris moves laterally. Semitendinosus inserts over the anteromedial aspect of tibia along with sartorius and gracilis, forming the pes inserine insertion, whereas biceps femoris, it inserts over the head of fibula. Now when we talk about biceps femoris, this muscle is again a complex muscle because it has two heads. A long head, which arises from ischial tuberosity, and short head, which arises from the femur. And both these heads, they have different nerve supply. So the long head is having its supply from tibial component of the sciatic nerve, whereas the shorter one, short head, it gets its nerve supply from the peroneal component of sciatic nerve. And all these hamstring group of muscles, as they are crossing two joints, hip joint as well as the knee joint, so again they are prone to sports trauma and avulsion fracture. So we can find avulsion of the ischial tuberosity in adolescent athletes as a result of pull from this muscle. Now let's see the sequential MR images. We are scrolling down. This is ischial tuberosity. As we are moving down, we can see the hamstring group of muscles have started appearing. So this is biceps femoris, this is semitendinosus, and this is semimembranosus. So as we are moving down, now semimembranosus is becoming more bulkier and semitendinosus is becoming tendinous. And we can also see that semimembranosus and semitendinosus are moving towards medial side, whereas biceps femoris is moving towards lateral side. And also semitendinosus, gracilis and sartorius, they are moving together. Now let's see muscles around the knee joint. So as we have already seen, the posterior muscles are semimembranosus, semitendinosus and biceps femoris. And anteriorly we have vastus lateralis, vastus medialis and vastus intermedius. Then on anteromedial aspect we have pes anserine tendon insertion, which comprises of sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus tendons. So we can see here sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus. Now posteriorly we have gastrocnemius, which has medial as well as lateral head of origin from the medial and lateral femoral condyle respectively. Then we have plantaris, which arises from the lateral femoral condyle, and the tendon courses between the gastrocnemius and soleus and they insert over the calcaneal tuberosity. Then we have popliteus muscle, which arises from the femur and it forms the floor of the popliteal fossa. The popliteal neurovascular bundle, they traverse superficial to the popliteus muscle. Popliteal muscle is also very important because it is related to the lateral meniscus and it traverses through the hiatus between the popliteomeniscal fascicles, and it is responsible for stability of the posterolateral corner of knee joint, which is important for the stability of knee joint. Now let's see the sequential MR images. We can see here vastus medialis obliquus. It is important muscle because it prevents lateral dislocation of patella. So if vastus medialis is weak, then patient can have lateral dislocation of patella. Here we can see this is lateral side, this is medial side. So here we can see biceps femoris and medially we can see all the medial group of muscles. Now as we move down, we can see medial head of gastrocnemius is taking its origin. And these three muscles, tendons, they are moving anteriorly. And this is semimembranosus. So as we are moving down, we can see that there is a potential space between medial head of gastrocnemius and semimembranosus tendon, and it is also location for the bursa, which when inflamed and distended with fluid, it forms Baker cyst. So as we move down, we can see semimembranosus tendon is getting inserted over posterior aspect of tibia medially. And the pes anserine tendons are moving anteriorly. So here we can see they are inserting over tibia. Now here we can see greater bulk of the gastrocnemius muscle and this is popliteus muscle.